Thank you, Mr. Chris Cooper. Since we've heard so much about the curcumin and the benefits, now we'd like to invite two traditional specialists to tell us their take on this very special element, curcumin, Western versus Chinese. And of course, first person on the list, she's a medical doctor for the past 30 years and has her own general practice. And she's none other than Dr. Elena. And also, next on the list is a maternal and child health specialist for the past 20 years and have her own healthcare center and have received various entrepreneur awards. Ladies and gentlemen, she's none other than Iris. So once again, please be hands welcome Dr. Elena and Miss Iris. And I'm pretty sure that there are a lot of you guys who have lots of questions to ask Dr. Elena as well as Miss Iris. So before anything, and wow, just talking about them, they are here with me. And of course, we'd like to have our first question to be posted to Dr. Elena. Why does inflammation occur?
Right. Thank you, Mr. Maguire, for the question. Okay, so there's a lot of buzz talk about inflammation nowadays, but what does it actually mean? I'll just briefly explain. Inflammation is our body's way of protecting itself from either infection, illness, mechanical injury, or toxins. Basically, it is our first line of defense. There are two types of inflammation, actually. Short-term or acute inflammation, and long-term or chronic inflammation. Acute inflammation is the good type, which is the body's normal response when something harmful or irritating affects our body. For example, when we get a cut, a bruise, or a burn injury. This response is also involved in illnesses such as sepsis, when there's bacteria in the blood. When the inflammatory response is short-term, it kickstarts our body's defense system. Hence, it will protect us from further damages and help us to recover faster. Acute inflammation comes on quickly and typically lasts a few days. However, note that it can also be fatal. On the other hand, chronic inflammation is the bad type. And this happens when the inflammation process goes on for too long, lasting for months or even years. Acute inflammation, if not resolved earlier, can also turn into chronic inflammation. Chronic inflammation is linked with a wide range of diseases, including heart disease, where it plays a major role in the buildup of plaques in the artery wall, a process known as atherosclerosis. And this, over time, can cause heart attack and stroke. Apart from heart disease, chronic inflammation also correlates with other diseases such as diabetes, obesity, eczema, allergies, digestive problems, Alzheimer's disease, other brain degenerative disease, autoimmune diseases, whereby our body's immune system mistakenly turns on itself, attacking various tissues in the body.
所以 Dr. Elena 所说的，好像这个发炎哦，真的是对身体很不好。 可是发炎呢，就好像一个给我们的这个身体的这个预防的信号，说哎有事情发生了。而且 Dr. Elena 有分享的就是有短期跟长期的这个发炎啊这个问题哦。短期的话呢来的话呢几天后就走了，可是要赶紧的去解决它。可是如果是短期的这个发炎不解决它的话呢，会变成长期的话呢，那个就很糟了。所以 给我来说，普通人来说呢，我觉得说最好不要发炎了，最好是要身体健康啊，这个是很重要的哈。Alright，so我们的这个 Miss Iris 可以跟我们分享一下，根据这个中医的看法，可以告诉我们呢更多关于这个姜黄素的提取物吗？姜黄素呢，这个就是说。
很早之前，在18世纪就被已经挖掘出来了。它是一种什么呢？是在这个姜类的那个根茎当中挖掘出来一个是二铜化合物。这个二铜的这个二铜类啊化合物，所谓的这个人们的定义是，就是说它是抗高抗氧化的，然后。 后来经过科学家们就是一个认定吧，就是它已经就是一个 多酚类的化合物。什么是多酚类化合物呢？它就是在我们这个，比如说一个生物当种植了之后，它这个成长的过程当中，它要有太阳，它要有风吹雨打，它要有外界的一切干扰，它有一个抗的高抗氧化这么一个能力，这个就是多酚化合物的一个具备的一个功能。所以姜黄素呢，通常呢就是被人们用来高抗氧化的这么一个食物。这个如果要是说这个问题就是说你这个问题今天提出来了，那么也就是说我们在很早，这个它的原产地是在我们的亚洲的南部，求证呢可以说就是说在我们的印度的一本书里面，这个印度的书呢它叫什么呢，它叫阿育吠陀。这本书里曾经就在18世纪已经在记载的这个姜黄素的存在。那另外呢也是至今到了已经有2500年了。所以通常现在人们都用来扩张血管啊，或者是来保健的作用。因为它比较符合我们的阴阳调和的这一个原理元素。后边我们会继续再聊这个。您看看。
So Iris has actually shared this curcumin. It's something very special. I actually didn't know. It's like, wow, discovered in the 18th century and in the usage, and people try to find certain elements and the components of it for all these 2,500 years. So it's something which is really deserving to know what this curcumin is. Yeah, and how it can help us. That is something very important, because I heard the way she said, regardless of whether how strong the wind, how hot the sun is, the element is still there. So we need to know more about this, right? So back to Dr. Elena, what can cause inflammation?
Okay, Mr. Maguire, there are a range of factors that can trigger inflammation, chronic inflammation. Predominantly our diet. Our diet plays a very, very important role in the triggering of chronic inflammation. A poor diet consisting of processed food and refined carbs with high sugar intake plays a major contributing factor in the development of chronic inflammatory diseases. I also have to touch a bit on the presence of advanced glycating end products, which are actually harmful compounds which are formed when protein or fat combine with sugar in the bloodstream. Foods that have been exposed to high temperature, such as during grilling, frying, toasting, roasting, tend to be very high in these compounds. And advanced glycating end products have also been shown to cause oxidative stress, which produces more free radicals and inflammation. Smoking is also a very important triggering factor. The harmful effects of smoking are very well known, but it's important to note that smoking tobacco is linked to increased inflammation throughout the body. Other factors like obesity, whereby obesity is an inflammatory trigger on its own, whereby fat cells will react with the immune system to increase more inflammation. Lacking of exercise is also a triggering factor. Excessive stress, either at workplace or home. In our current pandemic scenario, financial stress is also a very, very important stressor and can trigger inflammation too. Poor sleep, late nights, and also exposure to high electromagnetic frequency in our immediate surroundings can also contribute to inflammation.
So, Dr. Elena 所分享的什么东西可以导致到有发炎？其实他有分到几样东西啊。有一样就是关于饮食的，我每次跟那些老人家都说，吃东西要少油、少盐、少糖，不要一直吃去炸去很多油腻的东西是不对的。还有他也是有说的，就是抽烟啊，抽烟也是会导致这个发炎。还有饮食不对还是什么的，就是那些比较肥胖的朋友们啊，要注意一下，压力大啊，很烦啊，压力很大，不够睡啦。好像现在呢，我们的这个情况哦，很多人都是压力大又不够睡啊，所以这些就是很多这种东西会导致到发炎，所以他都分享了，所以我们现在都要回去的就是我们的 Iris，OK。 可以 Iris 可以跟我们分享，就是这个提取物，这个粉和粉末呢，有什么区别？
这个粉呢和这个素啊，这个是本质上的区别。比如说，我们现在好多人呢都有一个误解，我举一个简单的例子来说，比较好说明问题。就是说，我们呢有的呢客户呢，他呢肩膀痛，肩膀痛完了之后，他的老公就跟他讲：“你吃甜漆。”其实呢，他就认为就是说你血液循环不好，那么甜漆它是一个热的东西，它可以。 让你血液循环，他只是说把阴阳的调理的这个道理说出来了，但实际上是错误的概念。这个人们也是一样，就是说现在呢，你比如说我们还有一个客户，他也是，那月经不调，或者是他有一个，其实他的身体本来是寒，那么就是说他呢就可以就是啊，我去买那个听说那个姜黄粉比较有用，其实。 一market现在啊，市场上的这个姜黄粉有很多，那而且被人们取用的。你比如说，像我们煮的咖喱里面，其实它就来源于这个姜黄粉里面的这些姜黄素，来源于姜黄素。所以人们呢就认为我多吃就血液循环，就是这个道理。那么我们再回到来，其实外面市场卖的这些，比如说卖 1 kg 的这么一袋包装里面，其实它只有3到6%的这个姜黄素，所以呢，它的成分还有它的这个粉，这个是有本质上的区别，它只是占这个它的那个能量，是这样子。
Thank you, Aris. I feel that what she explained is many people have actually misunderstood between curcumin and turmeric, because one is the extract and one is just the powder. And of course, turmeric, I think most of us know, we always use inside the curry or whatever it is, you know, and so people think that, if I have this problem, I take turmeric, that's it. Actually, no, because we are focusing on curcumin, because that is the extract. The essence is all from there. I think it's what she's trying to say is the properties is stronger and more powerful, because you can buy a 1 kg of turmeric, but maybe the goodness of, you know, the turmeric is maybe 3 to 6%. So yeah, always go for the extract. That'll be better. Yeah. So let's go back to Dr. Alina. So doctor, can you share with us, does herbal or supplements help on reducing inflammation?
Okay, sure, Mr. Maguire. Well, herbals and supplements contain potent antioxidants. All this can help fight oxidative stress by neutralizing the free radicals and also help to reduce inflammation. But of course, ideally, it would be best to get our nutrients from whole foods as it's more readily available, more bioavailable. But throughout the years, one of the most promising natural anti-inflammatory compound is actually curcumin. Such that over the last 25 years, there have been more than 3,000 publications concerning turmeric and curcumin. Curcumin is the most bioactive component of turmeric. It is a potent inhibitor of NF-kappa-beta, and it hits every target in the body's chemical chain reaction, which induces inflammation. On top of that, it also works on the same receptor that are targeted by opioids or painkiller medication with zero side effects and are also non-addictive. However, one of the challenges is that curcumin is not readily absorbed. Hence, to increase its bioavailability, some manufacturers have started using the liposomal technology. To understand more, liposomes are basically a layer of fat similar to our own cell wall. When liposomes are wrapped around the curcumin molecules, the curcumin can make it pass the harsh acids in the stomach so that more can be absorbed. To sum it up, curcumin is a very, very strong, potent, very, very strong anti-inflammation agent and a very, very potent antioxidant.
Thank you, Dr. Lina. 他所分享的就是说呢，其实好像保健品什么东西呢，当然是对我们身体啊。 是非常的重要，可是要我们的身体里面要怎么接受呢？而且很多人都说啊， 哦，我们吃我们每天所有的蔬菜水果这些，对。可是给我来说，重点是刚才 Dr. Elena分享，就是这个 cucumin。这个 cucumin呢，它可以导致给到很多不同的人都可以接受，身体内都可以接受这个成分，所以它也是讲到科学里面有点东西，所以给我来说，我觉得人类呢现在就是为了这个姜黄素，他们知道。 发现姜黄素可以帮助很多人，他们把它的体内呢弄成给我们人类呢所吸收呢更快、更好、更可以达到更好的这个results. OK，来 ，let's back to Iris. Iris 可以跟我们分享这个姜黄素的提取物如何为人们带来健康的好处，还有谁应该和或者可以服用？
就是在中医上来讲，讲究的是12个经络。那么也就是说呢，这个食品呢和我们进入我们的身体，它达到调和的作用。你比如说，我们的寒体，那么进入它这个是进入我们脾经还有肝经。那么也就是说，我们的脾正常了，我们的肝正常了，那么我们的血液循环供血能力就强。 肝大家都知道是排毒的，那么脾呢是送给心脏的，那么也就是说你的心脏好了，那么你呢就可以很有 power， 很有力量，那么血液循环好嘛，所以它主要的一个带来的好处就是血液循环，所以一般来讲呢，我们会劝这个客户们，那么也就是说，如果你身体寒，你比如说你在空里的。 空气里的 office 里做工，时间很长，那么你身体势必是要凉的。那么也就是说，你喝一些这个姜黄素的东西，比如说咖喱了，它这个就是这些成分在里面的。那么也就是说，多服用一些姜黄素的这些东西，然后对我们身体达到调和的作用。这个是在那个中医上角度。 那么另外呢，还有我们一般的来讲呢，有的人呢在我们新加坡天气比较潮湿，那么每个人呢就是会出现风湿，那么老人也是可能以前营养不够嘛，所以造成了以后现在的器官又不是说有这么大的力量所给予你的全身，那么也就是说我们除了按摩，我们还有说除了运动之外，那么我们服用一点姜黄素。 这样对我们的身体也有好处，那么也就是达到你去风湿的作用。那另外还有呢，有的人呢就是，刚才我们大家也讲了，现在大家的压力都比较大，那么也就是说呢，它可以呢调和你的这个神经紧张的这一个元素，因为它是在中医上来讲，它是属阳的食物，那么阳呢就是给你一个力量，一个 power。 那就是说，它会给你一些很有力量的一个思维。那么也就是谈到这个，就是又很深的地方，我们又到了一个那个交感神经上，所以它会有利于交感神经的兴奋的，所以呢，这个也是对我们有好处，能可以改善抑郁症。抑郁症大家都知道，就是现在比较普遍。 包括孩子，包括产妇，包括我们一些工作上不顺心的那些这些群体，那么吃这个姜黄素是很有帮助的。那另外呢，还有一个我刚才说了，因为它入脾经，所以呢对心脏有好处。那么也就是说呢，我们呢可以呢心脏好了就可以我们的血液循环就好。所以大部分就是对于这些比较，我就说到这吧。 要说还很多这几种，
Thank you, Aris. Well, the way she explained is, the cucumin is more like for everybody, okay? And especially she mentioned something like now the situation is like a lot of people are having depression, which is true because of the pandemic. So she says that this cucumin can actually help lots of people who are having depression. And she mentioned something that you know as it's like a the energy of yang, okay? Wow, it seems like after listening to this, I think maybe after taking cucumin, I will look younger because I've got yang inside. Perhaps, I won't know. I think I'm going to start to take that, you know, I try and they'll get my hands on it very soon. So before anything, thank you very much, Dr. Alina and Ms. Iris. Thank you so much for being with us to explain more about how this curcumin is. Thank you so much. Take care and see you guys soon. Right. Thank you.